Hello learners, welcome to Cash Education, and today we will study the process of transformation by Agrobacterium which causes crown gall disease in plants. Agrobacterium tumefaciens is a phytopathogen which carries the TI plasmid, and this gives it the capability to infect plants with crown gall tumor. Now we'll study the process of crown gall disease. When a plant suffers wound injury, it releases chemical compounds acetosyringone and hydroxyacetosyringone as a part of its wound response. Agrobacterium, which is present in the soil, gets attracted to acetosyringone and hydroxyacetosyringone released by the wounded plants. Agrobacterium contains the TI plasmid, which has the vir genes. Two of the vir genes, vir A and vir G, are constitutively expressed by Agrobacterium. Vir A receptor protein is found on the membrane and cell wall, whereas vir G is an internally present protein. Acetosyringone from the soil binds to the vir A receptor protein and activates it. Upon activation, vir A, being an autokinase, undergoes phosphorylation. Phosphorylated vir A then activates vir G by phosphorylating it. Upon phosphorylation, vir G undergoes dimerization. This vir G dimer then begins the transcription of other vir genes by binding at its promoter. Let's zoom in to now see what happens at the tDNA region. This is a representation of the tDNA of our TI plasmid, and it is flanked by the left border and right border inverted repeat sequences. Two of the vir proteins, vir D1 and vir D2, bind at the right border. Vir D1 is a topoisomerase that unwinds the DNA helix at the right border and releases itself. Vir D2 is an endonuclease that then nicks at the right border. After the right border is nicked, Vir D2 begins to pull out the single-stranded tDNA copy from the TI plasmid. As the Vir D2 endonuclease continues to extract the single-stranded tDNA copy, a polymerase enzyme initiates the synthesis of a new single-stranded tDNA, which will replace the one that is being pulled out for transfer. The single-stranded tDNA copy, which is being pulled out by Vir D2 for transfer, is then bound by multiple copies of Vir E protein. Vir E protein is a single-stranded binding protein that protects it from the action of nucleases inside Agrobacterium as well as when it is transferred inside the plant cell. Nearly 600 copies of Vir E proteins bind to the single-stranded tDNA which is to be transferred inside the plant cell. The process continues where Vir D keeps pulling out the single-stranded tDNA copy, Vir E binds to this single-stranded tDNA copy, and the polymerase, which is synthesizing the new tDNA copy. After the entire single-stranded tDNA copy has been extracted, Vir D2 nicks at the left border sequence and extracts the complete tDNA copy which is to be transferred. Along with this, the synthesis of the single-stranded tDNA copy, which has now replaced the original one, is also completed. Now we have obtained our tDNA which is to be transferred inside plant cell and which should be integrated inside the plant genome. It should be kept in mind that Vir D2 remains attached to this single-stranded tDNA copy until the end and completion of the process. Let's zoom out now to see what happens inside the plant cell. Vir proteins such as Vir B then begins the initiation and synthesis of a channel or a tube for the passage of tDNA copy which has been extracted. Vir B11, another Vir protein, joins Vir B in the formation of this channel. This channel or tube, which is created for the transfer of the single-stranded tDNA copy, is similar to the conjugal tube observed in conjugation events in other bacteria. While the single-stranded tDNA copy is being transferred from the channel of VIRB and VIRBF11, another VIR protein, VIRD4, associates with VIRB and VIRB11. The association of VIRD4 to these channel protein provides stability to the channel. The single-stranded tDNA copy is finally transferred inside plant cell. VIRD2 is still attached to this single-stranded tDNA copy. After single-stranded tDNA copy has been inside the plant cell, the channel formation proteins VIRB, VIRB11 and VIRD4 disintegrate. Inside the plant cell, VIRD2 guides the single-stranded tDNA copy into the plant nucleus. Inside the nucleus, the tDNA then integrates in the plant genome by method of homologous recombination. After the integration of the single-stranded tDNA copy into the plant genome, the genes for auxin, cytokinin and opine synthesis are expressed and the plant cell undergoes uncontrolled division, leading to the formation of crown gall tumors. This is how transformation is accomplished by Agrobacterium in the presence of a TI plasmid. This is all for today. See you again next time. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. See you again.